Welcome everyone to this video about biophysical water productivity. In this video, we will look in detail in the aspects that affect water productivity. So, without further ado, let's start. We often talk about water productivity in agriculture, or more practically, about more crop per drop. Especially in recent years, policymakers, water managers, and investors engage in water productivity discussion. Why has the water productivity become so popular lately? Think a bit more? Well, yes, because we need to produce more food so that we feed the growing population, while at the same time water is becoming scarcer. If you consider that agriculture accounts for a large portion of total freshwater withdrawals, increasing agricultural water productivity can free up water for other sectors. Do you think that this is possible? Well, before we try to answer this million-dollar question, let's first look in detail on what water productivity is. Biophysical water productivity is the relation between biomass or yield produced per water consumed, the water that is actually evapotranspired, referred to as ET. Depending on whether biomass or yield is used for the calculation of water productivity, there is the biomass water productivity or the yield water productivity. How can you increase this ratio? Well, there are two ways, either by increasing the biomass or yield while at the same time maintaining water consumption stable or even decreasing it, or second, by reducing the water consumption while at the same time maintaining or even increasing biomass or yield. Now, let's look at these three parameters of biophysical water productivity, which are related to agronomy: the evapotranspiration, the biomass, and the yield. ETA, evapotranspiration, is the actual crop evapotranspiration that consists of transpiration and evaporation. Transpiration refers to the water that is beneficially consumed by the crop, and evaporation refers to the water that is non-beneficially consumed. Biomass is the total amount of organic material that includes the roots, the branches, the leaves, and the harvestable yield of the plant. Yield is the amount of biomass that is harvested, and as it makes sense, yield cannot exceed biomass, as yield is a proportion of biomass production. This portion is the harvest index, or the ratio of harvestable matter over the total biomass. Yield biomass and evapotranspiration are profoundly related to agronomy. If we reformulate the equation of yield water productivity, three important agronomic concepts appear: the harvest index, the transpiration efficiency, and the beneficial fraction. Let's now explain each of these three concepts. As I mentioned before, the harvest index is the ratio of harvestable matter to total biomass. Transpiration efficiency describes the plant's photosynthetic processes through which it converts atmospheric CO2 to biomass using energy and water. This is also called photosynthetic efficiency. Beneficial fraction is the ratio of water that is transpired for crop production over the total water that is evapotranspired. In other words, is the ratio between water that is beneficially consumed over the total water that is evapotranspired or consumed. It makes sense that the higher that these ratios are, the higher the water productivity. But how can you increase these ratios? Is this so straightforward? In this introduction video, we have looked at the definition of biophysical water productivity. We distinguished between the biomass and the yield water productivity, and we have identified three important agronomic concepts that relate to physiological plant processes: the harvest index, the transpiration efficiency, and the beneficial fraction. Going back to the $1 million question, can we increase these ratios to have higher water productivity? Well, it might not be as straightforward as it might seem. These ratios are profoundly constrained by agronomic plant growth processes and are affected by management and environmental conditions in a complex way. These are aspects that we will explore later on, so stay tuned.